Hi there and welcome to the Met Office forecast for the week ahead. Low pressure this week will bring a mixture of heavy showers and longer spells of rain, but one key difference compared to last week is that temperatures will be closer to average and we'll mainly lose those overnight frosts. For much of May so far, high pressure has been dominant across Greenland. That's been causing the jet stream to flow further south than normal. This south-shifted jet stream means that we're often in a dip of the jet stream, which leads to low pressure close to the UK and some very unsettled weather. We're also on the cold side of the jet stream, but compared to last week, instead of northerly winds, we've got southwesterly winds. That's why those temperatures are closer to average. And this is a fairly old area of low pressure, so it's churning up areas of rain or showers, and it will stay close by during the next few days. So we'll start off with Tuesday with some sunshine, Northern Ireland, Northern and Eastern England. Perhaps a touch of grass frost in some sheltered spots, but for most it's frost-free. In the southwest, it soon turns windy with some showers or longer spells of rain pushing through, and then showers break out quite widely during the morning across England, Wales, Scotland and Northern Ireland. Some wetter weather there clearing northwest Scotland, staying dull and misty in the far north. But away from the showers elsewhere, there will be some sunshine and it does brighten up considerably there across southern parts of England. That's where the highest temperatures will be on Tuesday afternoon, 17, 18, possibly 19 Celsius, somewhere in southeast and East Anglia. Staying cool where we've got the mist and low cloud lingering in the far north of Scotland. It's still there to some extent on Wednesday morning. Again, showers and longer spells of rain in the north and the west before heavy downpours break out just about anywhere into the afternoon. Best of the sunshine in the south will be during the morning before this system moves in by the afternoon, bringing some particularly heavy and persistent rain, most likely to Wales and the southwest by the afternoon. Away from that, still feeling pleasant enough in the sunshine because winds will be a little lighter compared to Tuesday, but temperatures, I think, a degree or two down on the previous day. Low pressure still with us on Wednesday, but some uncertainty about the system that brings the wet weather into the southwest later, and that's likely to move its way north slowly by the start of Thursday, not before dumping 30 mils widely across parts of Wales, the Midlands, central southern England as well, and perhaps 50 millimetres in some of the wetter spots. So we're still watching that system as it moves north, but some uncertainty on its timing and its northward extent on Thursday. It's likely to break up into showers anyway, and then showers will build elsewhere. So Thursday is another day of sunny spells and heavy downpours. The best of the sunshine will be in the south, where temperatures will rise up to 17 or even 18 Celsius. But it'll stay dull and misty in the north, and with more of an easterly breeze for parts of Scotland, certainly feeling cooler here with a lot of cloud cover and, like I say, showers or longer spells of rain. That peters out in the north on Friday. High pressure's trying to build in here. But for England and Wales, it's another day of, well, sunny spells to start, and then those blustery showers get going quite quickly. 14 to 17 Celsius generally, but feeling cool on the North Sea coast, especially for Scotland, where we'll have some mist and low cloud. And into Friday night, we're going to see that high pressure to the north start to move away as the jet stream pushes further weather systems in from the west. And Saturday, well, it looks more like more of the same. Sunny spells, but also longer spells of rain or showers throughout much of the weekend. Temperatures not far from average, so it looks like typical weather for the time of year. Some much needed rainfall, of course, but getting the detail right on where exactly we'll see the heaviest rainfall over the next few days, well, that's something that we'll keep you updated on. And you can follow those updates on social media. Bye-bye.